Guys, this is Dr. Sangeeta from Dental Pathshala, where we help you understand and learn dentistry better and easy. When today's topic is one of the complex topics which most of the students find it difficult to understand. So today's topic is the rake angle. So before starting with the rake angle, first we should be familiarized with the other components of a file or a burr. So talking about the components of endodontic file, we have flute, radial, angle, blade. See, blade is the part which cuts. Which cuts the surface, which cuts the debris, which cuts the walls of the pulp. So blade is the part which is doing the cutting thing. So if we are talking about blade, it is the working surface, it is also the cutting edge which is cutting, and it is also the leading edge. Leading edge means the which is facing the on the front. So the warrior which is on the front, who's fighting. So blade is that part who's cutting, who's doing all the cutting job. And relief, helix angle, rake angle, pitch and the taper. So taper we have already covered in the instrument standardization of the endodontic instrument. We have 2-degree taper, 4-degree taper or 6-degree taper. So tapering is the increase in the diameter, and this increase in the time diameter is of the percentage. There is a percentage of increase in the diameter. So as we increase the diameter, as we go from D0 or D1 to up to D16, so there is an increase in diameter at every 1 millimeter. So this percentage is the tapering. Talking about the flute. Flute is the groove which is present on the working surface of the file. Can you see these grooves? So this is our endodontic file. So these which we have drawn like this, these are our flutes. Basically this is the cutting edge, and which is the adjacent to the cutting edge is our flute. So this part is the flute. So this part is our flute. And if we look at a large version of a file, now the green part is the flute. Cutting edge is that part which cuts, which consists of blades. When it is exposed to any surface, it cuts the surface. So this is the blade part and the cutting edge. So which is adjacent to the cutting edge is our flute. It is the groove which is present on the working surface of the file. Also we have the radial angle, or the we can also say the marginal width. So we have cutting edge, leading edge, or the blade which is the working edge area. So the blade where the which is doing all the cutting part, and relief is the part which is relieved. So this red one is the relief part. Helix angle is the angle which is formed between the long axis of the file and the cutting edge. Suppose this is our cutting edge. So once you see this, this is our cutting edge, right? So this one is our cutting edge. The angle which is formed between the cutting edge and the long axis of the file. So can you see this long axis of the file and the cutting, and the angle between the cutting edges are known as the helical angle. Rake angle. What is now rake angle? So today's topic will be studying more about the rake angle. So rake angle is an angle which is formed between the edge if we section the file. Now once we section this file is going to be like this, right? So suppose this is our file. So the cross section, once we cut the file into half, so we are cutting this file into half, the cross section of the file, it is with the angle it is making with the blade. So this is our rake angle which we are going to study in the today's video in detail. So without further ado, let's jump on to the rake angle. Before we get started, make sure you subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon. That way you get a notification as soon as I release a video lecture now talking about the rake angle. So rake angle is an angle which is formed. This is a cross section. This particular diagram A is the cross section. Diagram B is the enlarged version of only just a part of this cross section. And C is also a cross section. Now this diagram, when we cut the file into in the cross section, so this is like we cut into the half, and then this half part, once we zoom it, it looks like this, or it looks like this. And this direction of the rotation of the file is always clockwise. We use it in the clockwise manner. So the direction of the file is like this. So the part which is going to cut or scrape the surface is our blade. As we all know, blade always does the cutting part, right? So either it is going to cut or it is going to peel or scrape. So if it is going to take the material in chunks, this is going to be a cutting action. And if it is just scraping onto the surface, if it is scraping the pulpal wall, that means it is doing the peeling action. Now this action is actually depend on the rake angle. This is the reason we are studying this rake angle, because in the files, if we talk about K file, H file, which one has the scraping action, which one has the cutting action? If we are talking about reamer or we are talking about file, we do reaming action. So we are doing we are inserting and we are doing either quarter or half rotation and then taking it out. So this is how we are working with the reamer. So it actually depends on the rake angle, how this angle is. This is the reason we are studying this rake angle. Now to understand the rake angle, first of all, this is the cross section, right? And I'm going to enlarge this particular view. So this is the center of the file, and the green color is our blade, so which is going to contact the surface first and which is going to cut the surface first. Suppose in particular this case, if the file is going to rotate like this, so this one, this surface is going to touch first. Now when it is going to rotate, this green part is going to touch first, and when this green part is going to touch first, now see, this green part is going to touch first and it is going to take away a little part of this surface also. So this is our rake phase, this is our working phase, this is our cutting phase, this is our leading phase. So this green phase is actually, and if we enlarge this view, now this green one is the this part, right? And the black one is the clearance phase. So this black one is the clearance phase. So this is also clearance phase. Now I have enlarged only this particular view. So in this particular diagram, the long axis of the tooth is coinciding. Suppose if we look at this diagram, to make it clear, this one is the long axis of the tooth, or we can say this of the file, or we can say the radius. This red dot is the radius of the circle, right? So this red dot is going to be the radius of the circle. This one, if you can see, it is not always coinciding. Is so I have made two diagrams in which one, this green line is coinciding. So in one, the leading edge or the blade is, or the rake face is coinciding in this diagram, and in this diagram this is not coinciding. So we have to understand first the rake angle. What is rake angle? So for that, this is the long axis of our file, and the rake face or the cutting face is like this. This one is the cutting, which is going to cut the surface. This is going to face it first. So once we are doing the motion, this surface is going to touch the surface, the pulpal wall or whatever the surface we want to cut, this part is going to face first. And this one is just the opposite of this. This is just the clearance. So whatever it is cutting, it is just clearing and throwing it off. So this is the clearance, because it is clearing the surface. Because see, once if we are digging up some land, so if we are just removing the part of soil and we are not throwing it, then it is going to get collected in the part which we are digging, right? So this clearance phase is throwing the whatever the part we are cutting. So this is our clearance, and this whole part is our edge angle. This is the edge angle, and the long axis of the file or long axis of blade or long axis of the burr, basically long axis of the burr to the, or the file to the long, to the rake face is known as the rake angle. The angle between the blade and the long axis of the file, angle between the cutting edge or the radius, angle between the rake face or the radius, one and the same thing. So basically it is just the angle from the long axis of the instrument to the cutting surface, to the cutting edge. So this angle is known as our rake face. I hope that you are clear up till now. This is the rake angle. This angle is the rake angle. This face or this side is our rake side, or we can say rake face or blade, because this is doing all the cutting part. And the leading edge, because this is coming first. See, once you start doing the rotation, this surface, suppose if particular this blade we are talking about, this green surface is going to first touch this surface which we want to cut. So the one which is coming first and touching first is the leading lead. That means this is leading the whole thing. So that means it is coming first. So this is known as the blade because it is doing cutting action. It is known as leading edge because this edge is coming first, or this is also known as the rake face. So the angle between the long axis and the rake face is known as our rake angle. It plays a significant role because we'll come to know if it is either this particular file is doing the scraping motion or it is doing the cutting motion. It depends on this. So up till now, as we know, rake angle is the angle between the rake face and the long axis or the radius. So this particular part is our flute, and this particular, the green part, is our rake face or the leading face or the cutting face, or we can say the blade. Now this rake angle can be of three types. It can be negative, positive and zero. So the negative rake angle is the angle which we have already studied. That means the rake face is going to be, for negative rake angle, the rake face is going to go before, is going to touch the tooth before the radius. So the rake, in case in which we have already discussed in this also, like in this also, the rake face is going to touch first before the radius. So the tooth surface or the pulp wall of the pulp cavity or the surface which we want to cut, if the face, rake face, or we can say the blade or the leading edge or the cutting edge comes before the radius, it is ahead of the radius. So this is our negative rake angle. And the positive rake angle is when the radius comes first and then after the radius there we have the cutting edge or we have the rake face. So this is our negative, in which the radius is ahead to the rake face or is ahead to the cutting face or ahead of the leading face. So because this one is the positive rake face, and the zero rake face is when the radius and the rake face coincides with each other. So let me give you an example. See, to explain it to you, now the negative rake face, the negative rake angle actually does the scraping part. So the scraping action is due to then if there is a negative rake angle, and the positive rake angle means it is doing the cutting part. So the cutting part, that means if suppose this is the blade, right? This is the blade. I hope you guys can see. This is the blade. Now this is the long axis, right? So this is the radius. Now when I am going, the radius is ahead, and when the face, or we can say the rake face, is, see, this is the radius, this is the long axis, and I am going, the radius is ahead, I am going angle before the radius, I mean after the radius. So the radius is ahead and the face or the leading face or the blade face or the rake face is behind the radius, and when we are doing this, that is our cutting action. So can you see this? This is doing the cutting action. So the long axis, when the radius is ahead, that means it is doing the cutting action. And once we, if we see the negative, that means if this is the long axis and we are going below the, that means the, which is the surface which is touching first, is our rake face. So when the rake face is touching first, it is doing the scraping action. So this is the scraping action which is done by, see, can you see this? So this is the our radius, and the angle, the first which is touching is our rake face. So rake face, the negative rake face is doing the scraping action, while a positive rake face is doing our cutting action. So for a negative rake angle, the scraping action, we need more force. So we need more, and heat, because of this friction, more heat is also generated, and there is more energy which is required, more horsepower is also required. And if we look at a positive rake angle, so a positive rake angle is less heat production. Can you see there is a less heat production because the friction is also less. So cutting efficiency of a negative rake angle is less, and if the cutting efficiency of a positive rake angle is more. So this is the significance of the rake angles in endodontics or of the burrs. So this is about the rake angle, and this is all about the rake angles. There are three possibilities. It can be positive, negative, or the radial or zero rake angle. So I hope that I have made it clear for you, the rake angle, which is the most difficult part to understand. And if you feel that you have learned something new today, then go ahead and hit the comment box and the like button, because this helped me to help you skyrocket your career and knowledge while you stay at home with your family. Stay safe.